I just wanted to give you a brief insight into what the planning entails for all these little trips that we're doing on our way around the British Isles. It's not just a case of getting in the boat and saying, "Oh, I think we'll go to Lowestoft tomorrow." So here's a little bit of inspiration from the captain about how we plan our routes
The
for the
Royal
next
We.
day. Absolutely. So this is a great one, though. Look at this.
So our problem on this one is that we're going from Ramsgate, which is here, up across the Thames Estuary to Lowestoft, which is here. And there's several problems with this. One is it's quite a long way, so it's about 73 nautical miles. The second one is that if you look at the currents, these arrows each indicate the current. Now, they're not all completely accurate. There's one here that's wrong. I'm sure that's not right because it's mixed in with others. But we've got a little slider down here where I can change the time. So from where we start, if we were to leave at 3 in the morning, we'd have a really strong current pushing us up towards the estuary. But we're not leaving at that time because I don't want to leave until we've had a night's sleep. So even if we were to leave at 5, 6 o'clock, even 6:15, we'd have a bit of help up here, a bit of current going up here. But then before very long, it's all going to turn against us. Now, received wisdom is that we should always try and cross the Thames Estuary with the current because of the fact that it makes us safer. But because we're going so far north, we're not going through all these sandbanks, which is the light shades here. We're going around the outside, which is the safest route. Because for where we're going, there's no gain in cutting across. So actually, although we're crossing the Thames Estuary, really we're just going around the outside of it. So for us, we're going to get up and go as soon as we can, maybe at sort of 7 o'clock, and we're deliberately accepting foul tide. Because we want to have a night's sleep, and because we're going to go so far that whatever happens, we're catching a full tide plus a little bit more on the end. So actually, there's not enough gain to make it worth getting up at 3 in the morning.
Just do the whizzy thing along the bottom again.
So I'm going to slide it forward from 7 o'clock or so in the morning,
It's
and you can
really
see the
satisfying.
current's with us. And as the day goes on, this is 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, and this is just us getting into the middle of the estuary, or getting towards it now, 10 o'clock. We're just getting to about here now and starting to get into it all. And now we start getting into the current coming against us. 11, 12, 1, 2, 3. And it's only at 3 o'clock or so it starts to die away. And then at about 3:30, 20 to 4, it turns and it helps us. So what happens now is towards the end of our long day, as we're getting up towards Lowestoft, we're starting to get an ever stronger current. Ignore this one, that's a data point that's wrong. The current's now helping us more and more. So as the day gets later, our ground speed will increase, our speed over the ground, our SOG as we call it.
So tomorrow is going to be a really scary day
No,
because
not scary.
no, it's going to be, I'm just telling our viewers that it's going to be a very scary day because we're going across the Thames Estuary, which is it's one of the most complicated plans we've ever done, for the following reasons.
Yeah.
I'll ask my assistant
So
to
the first one is
explain.
distance. Obviously, it's a long day sailing. If we were going to go further and we're out overnight, that's a different problem. But we're trying to get there during the day. And so it's a fairly long day. The second thing is we've got strong currents and we've got all these sandbanks. Now, if I was to zoom in slightly on here, you can see the problem. Now, if we were going over to Felixstowe or any of the other places over here, we've got some very complex routes to make, but
The
because
blue and green bits are bits that are very shallow.
yeah, the green bits are dry out completely. They actually you can actually walk on those at low tide at what's called chart datum. So when we're at the mean low water springs, you will expect to be able to walk on those bits, so they properly dry. We obviously can't go anywhere near those because we've got our keel down and stuff like that. So what we're doing is leaving, coming across here. So this dark blue bit here is actually deep enough for us, so we're using that. And we're coming up here and we're going next to, this is the other reason for it's complicated, there's lots of traffic, commercial traffic, and I mean a lot.
So I have a quick question here. Where's the channel into the Thames for
the main one,
main shipping?
the main one would be known as Black Deep, I think, and it's this one here. So this comes up
Oh,
here,
yeah.
and that's why this channel here comes up from the south, and it comes up this bit here and it turns, and then they go down the river there to avoid
Okay.
all the bits here.
Yeah, fair
Now, the
enough.
problem we've got is we've got to keep out of that VTS, TSS, the Traffic Separation Scheme. We don't want to be in that because we're not a commercial vessel and we're not at speed which makes us fit to be in there. So we have to come along outside that, between that TSS and the sandbanks. So we've got to flirt with the sandbanks in order to be safe from the high speed.
Yeah, I'm not sure how I feel about flirting with sandbanks.
Well, sandbanks are fine as long as you keep an eye on your position. But when we get to the top here,
we'll probably have that discussion off camera. So that's given you a basic flavour of what we have to do, what we have to do before each of our legs.
The rest of it's easy, but when we get up here, we've got some more sandbanks to look at. Yeah, so just to keep us happy.
It's all good fun. Anyway, hope that was interesting.